Oh yeah, baby, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise for this right here, y'all. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, baby. It's morning time. Let's get into this word and see what the word says. Okay? All right. Get into this word, man. See what the word says, y'all. It is morning time. I see you, Mother Horton. Good morning to you. Good morning. Good morning to you. It's morning time, Sister Jess. Good morning to you, Sister Hall. It is morning time. Y'all see this in the word, y'all. And y'all see it's in red. It's in red, so it's what Jesus said. Good morning to you, Sister Allison. All right. It is morning time. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. What's up, cuz? Good morning to you, Diddy. Listen, man, once again, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration. Morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again. Give God all glory, all honor, all praise. For he is truly deserving of it. He provided us this morning with the breath of life. He provided us with the breath of life this morning, man. And each and every day, as we continue in this journey called life, I find a newfound appreciation for how precious life is. As I look at everything that's going on around me, look at where God has brought me from, I have a glimpse of where God is taking me to, and I just see how important life is, man, how precious it is, that it could be gone at any moment. Hey, good morning to you, Carlos. What's up, bro? Thank you for tuning in, man. Just talking about how precious life is, man, and how we appreciate life, you know. I met with some sisters yesterday, some dynamic sisters who are doing phenomenal work right now here in the Capital District. And as we said and we met, from the time that we was, you know, planning to get together up until the time that we dismissed on last evening, multiple shootings, you know, in the Capital District, multiple shootings, you know, multiple people injured. A 17-year-old and a 23-year-old lost their life. You know, a lot of people being affected by gun violence, things that are going on, you know, not just in here, right here in the city of Troy, in the capital region, but elsewhere, all over the nation, even global. There's a lot of things happening. You know, we know the pandemic. That's global. That's across the globe. There's a lot of things happening. We're in a different time that we're living in right now. And so, as we continue on this journey called life, it's time we really take a hard look at our lives and our footprint and how we are maneuvering and the things that we are doing. What are we really doing? What with this opportunity? Like, what are we doing? Are we squandering it away? Are we just throwing it away? Are we just living life any type of way? Are we making our mark? Are we seeking out our purpose? Are we really doing things that bring God glory, bring honor to the kingdom? So this morning, man, we're looking at Matthew chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6, and we find Jesus speaking. And he's talking to the people, and he's letting them know about some of the things that they're doing and how they should really be doing what they're doing. And so before I go any further, we're going to go ahead and go into our prayer, and then we'll look at the word, all right? Thank y'all for tuning in. If y'all don't mind, y'all hit that share button. Let's get this message out to as many people as possible. Let us pray. God, our Father, as we come to you in the mighty name of Christ Jesus, we thank you for you being who you are first and foremost. We thank you, oh God. We love you. We appreciate you. We give you praise. We bow our knee and our heart to you, O God. As we come together in this fashion, we ask that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, and allow your Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth and revelation. This is our prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray it. Amen, amen, and amen. So the reading of the word comes out of Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. And the word reads, "Take heed that you do not do your charitable deeds before men to be seen by them. Otherwise, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. Therefore, when you do your charitable deeds, do not sound a trumpet before as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may be glorified by men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward. But when you do a charitable deed, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, that your charitable deed may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will himself reward you openly." May God add a blessing not only to the hearer, the reader, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. So this is Jesus. He's coming back. And, you know, a few months ago, we talked about the great Sermon on the Mount. And this is a part of that sermon where he came out and he actually addressed the people about all the things that was going on, all the different things that was happening. He was talking to them about really about getting that yoke off their neck. Because they had a yoke on their neck, and people was telling them that you had to do X, Y, and Z. And if you didn't do it this way, that it wasn't blessed. And if you was living and you had this going on. And so I invite you to go back and look at it in Matthew chapter 5. I think we went, I know we went into it in a pretty lengthy discussion. I think we went into it maybe a couple weeks. But this is a continuation from this great sermon, where he's addressing the people. And so he's speaking to them. He's speaking to them. He's letting them know that, man, listen, you don't have to let anybody know what you're doing. You don't have to let them know. Because when you do it in that fashion, and you're looking for a pat on the back from an individual, or you're trying to show somebody else, or you're trying to show off to them and let you know what you're doing, then that's your reward. Whatever you get from them, that's your reward. That's your reward. You don't have to. I've seen a post on Facebook where it showed like a man giving somebody, he appeared to be like a homeless man, some bread, but at the same time he taking a selfie so that it could be seen that he giving the homeless man some bread. And he's saying that's your reward. Whenever you do that, whenever you sound the trumpet, or whenever you're doing, he said, man, he goes even further, Jesus does, and he says, don't even let your left hand know what your right hand is doing. Don't even let them know what you're doing. Because what you do in secret, God sees in secret, and he's going to reward you openly. And I know it's a fine line, because, you know, I do a lot of community work and I do different things. And so I do post a lot. I post a lot. I'm not even going to sit here and try to sugarcoat. I post a lot. And the posting is not to brag, but to bring light to different things. When you see me posting about my marriage, that's promoting marriage. That's putting marriage out there, because I feel like that's not talked about. When you see me posting with my sons, that's showing a father and a son relationship, or my daughter, a father-daughter relationship. When you see me posting things in the community, that's showing how we're bringing the community together and trying to promote and get people on board. But it's not just to say, oh, look at me, or look what I'm doing. And that's, when you do that, that's your reward. And I would rather have what God has for me. I would rather have what God has for me than any reward that any man could provide to me. Because see, when God gives, God, he is the giver of life. And when he gives to you, man, listen, man, he gives you, he gives you life, and he gives you a life more abundantly. That's what he said that he wants to give. And so if you're seeking the attention from individuals, And that's all that they can give you is attention. When God can provide you with life and health, strength, opportunities. He can provide you with mended relationships. You'll be able to go back and mend relationships that have been destroyed. He can provide you with so much more. So when you're doing it and when you're moving in that fashion, make sure you're doing it for the right reason. You don't got to let everybody know what you're doing. There's a lot, man. Listen, come on. Like I said, I post a lot, but there's a lot I don't even post. There's a lot of things I done did for some people, man, I won't even talk about. And I'm not talking about like small things. There's some things that I've done that I don't even discuss. Ways I've assisted people, ways I've come to help people out. Things I've really done that it don't need discussion. It don't need discussion. Because I did it from here. I did it from here, and I did it so that God could receive the glory. People are failing to believe in people nowadays. People have been, and Jesus, hallelujah, and Jesus uses the word hypocrite in verse 2. People have been messed over. People have been screwed over so much. People have been screwed over so much that people are losing faith. Huh? People are losing faith in individuals. They're losing faith, man, listen. The church, if y'all don't know, excuse me, I'm here to tell y'all the church is under attack. People have lost faith in the church. I'm being for real. So much has happened under the name of religion, inside the walls of the church, under the name of the church. People have lost faith in the church. They don't feel like it's real. They don't feel like the church is addressing issues. People has lost almost all faith in our elected officials. They feel like that's just a show that they don't genuinely care for the people. Huh? People have lost faith in the police. So right now, as we have this opportunity to put our faith on display, we don't have to do it in a fashion where it's not about, that it's about bragging, but it's about allowing people to see genuineness, allowing people to see there still is people who are genuine and sincere that really care. And sometimes that don't revolve letting nobody know. That may be walking up to somebody, man, and just, you know, you seeing them and you know that they're struggling and just slipping them some money in their hand. Or catching somebody and just saying, hey, man, how can I help you? How can I assist you? You see individuals in your community. You see a child, man, and you see that child going through it and just maybe speaking to that child. You see a young man who, you know, you just see him wandering lost, speaking to him. Outside of a camera, outside of, you know, sounding the alarm, outside of sounding the bullhorn, and seeing if there's a need that you can help meet. That's what it's all about. Because God, it says in verse 4, that your charitable deed may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret himself will reward you openly. God sees all things. God sees all things. And so, man, I pray that y'all got something from the word this morning. Once again, that's Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. I encourage you to read your word and read it in its entirety. Even if you got to go back to Matthew chapter 5 so you get a great understanding of this Sermon on the Mount and see that Jesus had came to recalibrate the way the people was addressing, the way the people was living, the way the people was the way the scribes and the Pharisees was handling, the church people was handling the people. He came to recalibrate that. He came to reshift that. The way that the tax collectors and the politicians, the way that they was handling the people, Jesus came to correct that. That's what he came to do. Like somebody put on my wall this morning, he came to unify the people, to bring them together. And that's what our job is. But don't take my word for it. Please, y'all, get into the word for yourself. Please get into the word for yourself. That's Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. When you read your word, y'all could say, if you feel like it, jump into the comment box and say, I read my word. I love y'all. God bless you. Remember, faith over fear, God over everything. Together, we have made love great again, because love has never lost its power. It's lost its popularity. Shout out to each and every single one of y'all who've logged on this morning. Shout out to you, Pastor Honor. Shout out to you, Anissa, Miss Reggie. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Miss Ellie, Councilwoman Kim. Good morning to you. Y'all don't mind, man. Y'all hit that share button. Let's get the message out to as many people as possible. They need to hear the word, man. They need the word right now. Believe it. I love y'all. God bless you. Catch you on the next time.